guys, welcome back to Rita's World. I am back again with an update on our batch cooking. So I previously did a video on our grocery shopping haul and also a preparations video for the kitchen. So yesterday evening we did packing the food and putting it back into the fridge. I want you guys to see that part just now. Is I want to clean the pantry, which I call the store because it's really our store. The kids are home for holidays, so there's too much noise in the neighborhood. So today I just basically want to clean it up, organize it, and remove whatever we don't need in the store to the kitchen. I've always told you that I like micromanaging that part of the house because when there's food in plenty, sometimes it gets misused. So I'm going to show you today how, which I think I've already done in a previous video again, how I pack the food, how I organize the pantry. For me, the pantry basically is there for the rainy days. Like I always say, when you're a business person, there are months that are good, there are months that are bad. So for me, batch cooking really is like a safety net for me. So once I have the money, I shop. It doesn't matter if the month is bad. It doesn't matter if the next 2 months are bad. As long as we have the food, we shall survive. Okay, so you know, when you have kids, the worst thing that can happen is for the kids to sleep hungry. So yeah, so let me take you and show you how the pantry looks like. Also, I want you guys to see how the fridge looks like at the moment. Someone was asking me on my DM, how come I don't have like juices and sodas or all that in my fridge? And that is because akuna letter. And that is because in a house like this, when you have kids, there's no way you can put like juices in the fridge because watakunywa na siku moja zote. And there's no way you can keep alcohol in the fridge because that means that they're able to access it. So you have to find spots in the house where you can keep them. Like for me, I keep them in a certain kabati which I lock thoroughly. So I want to show you guys how the fridge looks like. This is how it turned out. So that is food for the whole month. That's done. So basically that is supposed to serve us for at least a month. Also, we have the pantry here, which is looking very ragged and dirty. This is the situation in the pantry. I just want to bring all of it out, clean it up, and then remove what I need in the kitchen, and whatever it is that we won't need for the next at least 2 weeks, I leave it in the pantry. So that's how you basically able to manage what comes out of the pantry. So let's do that, and then I'll show you guys the after. this is how the store turned out. As you can see, I managed to arrange everything that I needed to arrange. That's how it looks. So this is what now we have left after removing the things that we need for the month. There's rice there, there's cooking oil here, and the rest of the shopping is up here. We like this Weetabix normally for breakfast, especially for the days when we have nothing ready for breakfast. So that's how the store looks. Also, I've managed to put aside most of the things that will be used for the next 2 weeks up there. So until that is done, nobody gets into my store. I'm the one who manages everything from here. As you can see, the key has my car keys, so everywhere I go, it goes. If anyone needs anything, they come to me and ask me. So that way, I'm able to manage what leaves this store. Okay? So that is it. That is all for today, guys. See you guys in our next video.